Hello again. We are going through the front yard talking about ways to bring more and more pollinators into the garden, one of which is planting flowers amongst your vegetable gardens. We planted nasturtium seeds along with our herbs. We have stevia, we have oregano, we've got summer savory, we've got some more oregano and lavender. And I like that the lavender and the nasturtium's doing well. We've got some comfrey along with our snapdragons right next to our bean plants, which is kind of cool. We've got some really amazing yellow daisies. I'm sure that's not their technical name, but I call them yellow daisies. And again, we have the nasturtiums. And yes, we have a lot of grass in that garden because the straw I used had grass seeds, but it's just grass and not weeds, so we're letting them go. And it's funny because it's actually protecting my Brussels sprouts from other critters, so it's keeping the bugs away. In the meantime, the beets are going up the poles. Beans, not beets, what am I saying? The beans are going up the poles. We still have lots and lots and lots of snapdragons. And again, the beans. Hello there, Jay. We also have our local blue jays. But yeah, the bean plants are doing well. We have harvested all of our garlic, and now we're focusing on the beans, which we're getting to go up our poles, which is, again, pretty cool. So I've got quite a few pole beans going, and I've got snapdragons along with the marigolds to keep the critters away, bug critters. And I've got hollyhock in there as well, and borage. I think I've got some really beautiful borage plants, as you can see. The winds come up. Along with beautiful Florence fennel. And I like the fennel because I actually use the fronds, but I also love the seed heads. The bees love them. And then at the end of season, I get really good fennel seeds for my sausages and my Italian sauces.